Hey, hello, welcome. I'm Ruud and I'm on a mission to build the ultimate dust separator for a small workshop with big tools. Because this was the moment I knew, I created myself a dust problem. And I accidentally fixed it by building my own version of the DIY dust separator from Filson Guitars. It performs extremely well at the efficiency above 99% while running my planer. In this video, I will build the hole separator again, only this time out of 150mm acrylic tube you can buy in Europe. The last separator I built in January out of 6-inch PVC tube I bought on Amazon. Only the shipping cost of this pipe was $75 to get it in Europe, and that is a lot comparing to the price of the tubes themselves. This project needed many hours to print, and I did the most of it off-camera. Only there is one issue I like to address, and that is printing of the mirrored impeller. Due to curling on the edges, the back side was not smooth. I printed the last separator back in January, and the room temperature was much lower than it's now in the summer. First of all, you don't need the mirrored impeller. It's just for the looks and not for performance. One of you had a brilliant idea to address this issue due to the counterclockwise printing of the bubble up slicers. He used a Orca slicer with the clockwise print settings, so the overhang will print at last and the curling will not occur. I needed to print the file with an open door and the top cover off, and that printed very smoothly. So now all the printing is done, it's time to go to the next phase of the build, and that is cutting the acrylic tubes so the collection ports can fit into it. I made some jigs for that, and we need to remove the support material first. And it's just a repeat of the rest of the parts, so I won't bore you with that. I designed the cutting jigs with a flat face on the bottom, so you can put them flat on the workbench. There is also a lip where you can slide the tube against. And when you have the orientation right, you can fix the jigs with some tape. I fixed the tube to the workbench with an old piece of wood and some clamps, so it will not move while we cut it with the oscillating multi-tool. And I cut parallel to the jig. The fumes of acrylic are toxic, so protect yourself and open a window if you can. So acrylic really likes to melt, and I took a blade with bigger teeth for the last part, and that went really well. So now it's time to clean the edges with a vial or sanding paper, and you need to take your time for that because acrylic is brittle and will not flex like PVC does. Don't ask. The front dustport is not symmetrical. It has two lips on it, and the front lip has a big chamfer on it. Don't force the tube into place and take your time to enlarge the cutout if necessary. If you made it so far, this was the hardest part of the build. And now it's time for the inside of the separator. And that's where these parts are for. The first thing I got is the impeller, and the shroud needs to go on top. there are notches, so it will lock into place, and you need some super glue on that to fix it. The heart of the separator is ready now, to fit inside of the tube. Only there is a groove in the shroud that fits inside of the lip of the front of this port. So we need to take this apart and put the assembly into the tube. This is a tight fit, so take your time for that. The way I designed this assembly for the PVC version of my separator, it definitely won't work with the acrylic one. Acrylic is in no way flexible, and it snaps off really fast. So I need to redesign this, because this assembly is also not an option with the lips on this design. And I think I can remove the lips, so we don't need them anymore. So I save the patient for now with some red tape, and I put the assembly back together and tied it up a strap to see how much force we will need to shift the assembly without the lip. You need some force, and I don't think the dust is that strong, but to better be safe than sorry, I will redesign the lip so it has more clearance. So after reprinting the front dashboard and the shroud with the groove that has more play, assembly and disassembly is much easier now. This time I don't pre-assemble all the parts first, because the shroud fits through the cutout of the dashboard. It has a small chamfer on it, so you can slide it back more easily. You need to pre-glue all the spots on the impeller without putting glue on the tube. And in this design, the O-ring is missing from the shroud to find out if you can do without. It makes the assembly easier. In my design, I don't use silicon glue to seal all the parts together. I use O-rings instead. I want to be able to take things apart easy for future testing. Only the seals I use in my previous separator, they are much too loose. So I ordered new ones instead. And they are cheaper and has a smaller diameter. When you push the inlet into the tube, you need to watch out for the lip inside of the tube. That was made for a 30 degree inlet variant, so the orientation was always right. For the inlet and the outlet Y pieces, I reused the parts of the old separator. They are interchangeable, so that will fit. The assembly of the European version of the separator is ready now. And let's talk about some costs to build it this far. I used 5 spools of PLA from about 85 euros. The O-rings were 30 euros for 10 and the acrylic tubes were 60 euros for the 2. That was cut on length. So with some shipping cost, it's about 200 euros to build this version of the separator. In part 2 of this build series, I'm going to reprint the Y pieces, because now they need support, and when we can eliminate that, it saves costs and print time. I'm also going to build the base plate for the separator and show you how I included my waste bins into the design. So stay tuned for that, and thank you for watching for this video. Houdoe!